issues today.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please stand for the arrival of the official party and the national anthem. Good morning, distinguished guests, Captain Slayton, Master Sergeant Chippy, Master Sergeant Brazil, ladies, gentlemen, fellow service members, and family members. I'm Tech Sergeant Freeman, your mistress of ceremonies, and I would like to welcome you to today's graduation ceremony. This morning, we are pleased to have all of you present as we honor the graduates of Class 18001 and 18002. I now would like to introduce the officer in charge of the Advanced Culinary Training Division, Chief Warrant Officer 4, Joseph A. Wisniewski.
Good morning, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, fellow service members, family members, and guests. Today we're here to graduate Advanced Culinary Skills Class 1801-1802 on their accomplishments throughout the 5-week program. They've endured tough regime instructors who have evaluated them on classical cooking techniques, food preparation, organizational skills, and sanitation. They have demonstrated potential to cultivate a higher level of culinary skills. Some of you graduating today will go on to serve as enlisted aides, work in executive dining facilities for flag officer. Others may serve in your respective garrison operations. Wherever life may take you from this moment forward, on your culinary journey, remember your professionalism is ever-changing and culinary knowledge is there to be gained. The knowledge you have gained here is meant to be shared at all levels in all facilities. Always work to refine your skills, be humble in your heart, and strive to learn as much as you can. Once again, congratulations on your accomplishments. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Wisniewski. Now I would like to introduce our guest speaker, Sergeant Major retired, Mark W. Warren. Sergeant Major Warren retired as the Army Food Service Sergeant Major in October 2016 after completing 33 years of military service and is currently a food service consultant with the Logistics Management Institute. During his military career, Sergeant Major Warren served with the U.S. Army Culinary Olympic Team for 25 years. During his Army service, he led 8 department-level Philip A. Connolly Award-winning teams for field and garrison. He is the 2013 American Academy of Chefs recipient of the Lieutenant General John D. McLaughlin Professionalism Award. His leadership roles include team captain of the 2004 U.S. Army Culinary Arts Team and team manager and pastry chef for the year 2000 team. Sergeant Major Warren is a certified executive chef and served as ACF certified culinary judge and ACE chef certification evaluator. For his complete bio, please refer to the back of the program. Please help me in giving Sergeant Major Warren a warm welcome.
Thank you for your comments. The words were pretty resounding, huh? Every once in a while, they take an old guy like me and dust them off and pull them off the shelf to come and speak to a great group of young service members like yourselves that have just experienced a training environment that is unlike any other. First of all, I'd like to say good morning to the visitors, the family members, the distinguished guests, the VIPs, and most of all, the students of the two classes that are graduating today. Today, I wanted to talk a little bit about the Culinarian's Code. The Culinarian's Code was adapted by the American Culinary Federation as a governing code for chefs. And through the years, from the time I was a young chef to today, the code has evolved. And if we looked at the code today, it would say things, I pledge to share my professional knowledge and skill with all culinarians. So as a takeaway from your training environment, your commitment back to the field is to take what you have learned, mentor those who do not know, whether they're your peers, your seniors, or subordinates alike. It says, I will place honor, fairness, cooperation, and consideration first when dealing with my colleagues. And under the Department of Defense, we always teach our service members to always treat each other with dignity and respect. So many times in a kitchen environment, we have a sense of getting excited. Those people with the skills that others don't have a tendency of overwhelming those who are developing. So take that into consideration about how you take your skills that you've acquired during this training and your experience and are able to relay those back to your subordinates, peers, and seniors alike. The code also tells us that it will I will protect the members of the use of unfair means, unnecessary risk, and unethical behavior. As our society is evolving today, you can't turn on the news without seeing an issue of unethical behavior, whether it's through business practices, relationship issues, or harassment. Always treat those that you are with and around with the dignity and respect that they deserve. Always conduct yourself as you would expect people to conduct their business with you. The Culinary Code also talks about using your position for greater gain, personal gain. We talk about that in all of our services. It doesn't matter the uniform you wear, everyone's code of responsibility tells you to make sure that you do not use your position to obtain personal favor. Well, so that's the opening part of the ethical situation and dilemma we have. You've represented your respective services well. You've attended the highest level of culinary training any school in the Department of Defense has. And each of you today graduating has executed the skill that you need to obtain to validate that you are of that capacity. Now everyone gets to go out and put that advanced culinary skills training course on their docket. So when they're reviewed for promotion, you'll stand out above your peers. So congratulations on that. It's my honor to be here today and have been invited by the Advanced Culinary Skills Training Department. Thank you very much. Just a little bit that was not in my read ahead. In 1994, I came to Fort Lee, Virginia as a instructor at the Joint Culinary, back then it was the Army Center of Excellence, to be the initial instructor, trainer, writer of the Advanced Culinary Skills Training Course. So it's been a pleasure through the years to see how the course has evolved, to see the soldiers, sailors, airmen, marine, coasties that have been graduated and funneled through the process, and to see the great things that they have achieved along the way. Today, I would like to leave you with 8 essential traits of a professional chef. Now, this isn't a sermon, and you heard the word eight. I know all of you are about ready to hit the road. So I'm going to briefly go over those 8. Number 1, first and foremost, humility. It's easy to have a professional that is exceptional, that executes above every level of degree, but when that person has an ego or exaggerates themselves, they become unapproachable. Keep yourselves humble. Keep yourselves approachable. Do not let your skills overwhelm those around you to the point where it degrades your capability of being a good leader. Punctuality. I think every one of us here has had to stand or show up to a formation at a given place and time in what uniform. And that is embedded into your military spirit. It's embedded into your who you are. But in the food service environment, always be 15 minutes early. If you're a manager, give them 5 minutes. As I grew up, I learned as a young soldier, you're there before the boss gets there. And the boss comes a couple minutes late so that he doesn't have to recover from someone who is late. Give your soldiers, sailors, airmen, marines an opportunity, but practice what you preach. Focus. We all enjoy talking. Sometimes you just need to know when to shut up. It may sound blunt, but it's the truth. If you're the only one talking in a kitchen, you probably shouldn't be. You probably should just refrain from it unless you're the one in charge. Pay attention to what's being directed. Focus on what you are doing. Focus on what you are making and prepping your mise en place. You all learned that terminology, huh? And focus on learning what each station in your kitchen must do to be productive. Endurance. A career in the military or any other is not a short race. It is a long-term endurance. As you heard today, I served 33 years in the active, plus 3 years in the National Guard. But I started cooking at the age of 14 in 1977, so that should tell you about how long I have been involved or around food service operations. It's endurance. Keep your heart in the right place. Without the passion for what you do, you're probably not going to succeed. Find what it is you're passionate about, and the endurance part comes easy. Assertiveness. Yes, chef. That's all your chef wants to hear. Or if it's your NCO or your gunny or your master sergeant or your tech sergeant or whoever that is, the response should be yes, meaning that you're listening and ready to follow whatever their guidance is. Stop making excuses, stop over-explaining things, and lead from the front. Make sure you can teach what you expect your staff to know. That's a tough one. Make sure you can teach what your staff needs to know. This course that you have just ventured through has given you skills that you should be able to share and teach and mentor others with. But every time you change a job, make sure that if you're a person in charge, you know every position in the shop. It's very important. Curiosity. I'm on number 6 of the 8, by the way. Our industry would be obsolete if it wasn't for the human's natural tendency for pursuing curiosity. In the beginning, you should ask all the applicable questions. You should become a sponge. Soak it up. Then, as the fundamentals become ingrained, start pushing your boundaries. Don't ever question the why, question the why not. Cooking is limitless, and you're blind if you fail to see it. As I've been in the food service industry through the years, I have noticed the natural progression and development of culinary arts. From the times when we would think that a sundae was a great dessert in a nice restaurant, to the point where today we use things like molecular gastronomy. We learn terminologies and use things like glaçages for desserts. Sir Picard knows a lot of that stuff. You learn all the mother sauces and the derivatives of them. So as you progress with your learning, you also progress with the capability of self-expression in the kitchen environment. The greatest chef of all time, so the chef of chefs, the chef of kings, gentleman by the name of Escoffier, if y'all haven't ever heard of him, I encourage you to research and find out who Escoffier is. His claim to fame was that he created the kitchen brigade. He changed the structure of a kitchen facility and put down in writing what classical dishes are today. I encourage you, as you develop your own classics, pen and ink, put them down so that they will remain for all times. One day we may be talking about you. Fortitude. Eventually you will fail. We all do. No one is perfect. You will prepare something that is so awful, the only place that it is suitable for is the dumpster of regret. It's a true statement. One day, sooner or later, you will be put in your place because it's the natural tendency of the kitchen. Embrace it. The criticism you receive may be the harshest thing you're ever told, but we will tell you this will make you better. We will be willing to take the beat down and then stand right back up and become better from it. In a professional kitchen, no one's perfect. Everyone makes a mistake. But if you're not following prescribed guidelines, expect to get that beat down. As a supervisor, when you are the supervisor, you're that person that maintains the goals and the standards and sets the conditions for excellence or failure. So, those are the eight attributes of a professional chef. They've been told to me a couple of different times in a couple of different ways, but they are what they are. I know that today, as you graduate, you have other thoughts on your mind about seeing your family, the travel you have to make, or returning back to your duty assignments to make things better, or to make changes from what you've learned here today. You have also made relationships. Nurture them and keep them, because there will be people you were sitting next to that you will see again 20 or 30 years from now. And you'll be able to look back on this with fondness and excitement. Today I speak to some of you that I've impacted or worked alongside of in some life. Sergeant Cerna at one point was a PFC underneath my tutelage. I apologize for anything that he has said, done, or created in the course of the training that was not reflective of excellence. But I think he always has made me proud, because he's one of the hardest working non-commissioned officers that I've ever known. Unfortunately, I didn't get a chance to meet each of you personally, work side by side with each of you. But in the future, if you ever want to or have an opportunity, I'd be happy to come and pay you a visit. Good luck, Godspeed, and congratulations on completing the Advanced Culinary Skills Training Course. Cool.
Thank you, Sergeant Major, for those encouraging, inspiring words. Ladies and gentlemen, please feel free to move forward to take photographs of the graduating class as they receive their diplomas. We will now present the graduation certificates for class 18001 and 18002. Beginning with the Distinguished Honor Graduate, to earn the Distinguished Honor Graduate designation, you must obtain a grade point average of 95% or higher and you must successfully pass all exams the first time. This designation is reserved for the individual that displays exceptional qualities as a chef and a student. There is one student from class 18001 and one student from class 18002 that has met the requirements for this designation. The Distinguished Honor Graduate for 18001 is Staff Sergeant Robion Fountain. Honor Graduate for 18002 is Staff Sergeant Orlando Cerna. To earn the Honor Graduate designation, you must obtain a grade point average of 92% or higher, and you must successfully pass all exams the first time. This designation is reserved for the individual that displays exceptional qualities as a chef and a student. There is one student from class 18001 and one student from class 18002 that has met the requirements for this designation. The honor graduate for 18001 is Staff Sergeant Samantha Perez. Honor graduate for 18002 is Staff Sergeant Justin Chase. We will now present the diplomas for class 18001 and 18002. Please hold your applause until the last graduate has received their diploma. Staff Sergeant Alan Ball. Staff Sergeant Loanne Brooks.
Staff Sergeant.
Culinary Specialist, First Class, Gilbert Cardenas. Culinary Specialist, Second Class, Samuel Coffey. Sergeant Frederick Delgado. Staff Sergeant Myra Easter. Technical Sergeant Perla Hernandez. Corporal Alexander Jones. Sergeant First Class, Becky Kennedy. Staff Sergeant Aureli Laraquente. Master Sergeant Erica Lark. Staff Sergeant Jesse Long. Staff Sergeant Ryan Nielsen. Culinary Specialist, Third Class, Stephen Porter. Staff Sergeant Caroline Field. Okay. Culinary Specialist, Second Class, Brandon Turner. Staff Sergeant, Dane Wallace. Sergeant, First Class, Ryan Wienhold. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause to the graduates of Class. Now in closing, thank you, sirs. Now in closing, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all of you on a job well done in completing and passing this milestone. Remember, as professional military chefs, your training never stops. Once again, congratulations from the Advanced Culinary Training Division. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Armed Forces Medley and the departure of the official party. Gentlemen, this concludes our ceremony. Thank you for attending. Class dismissed.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. There ain't no doubt.